Hey ladies and gentlemen, Steven here from Redolessence and welcome back to another video. Thank you so much for joining me today. I really appreciate it and I hope that this video finds you well. In today's episode, we're going to be focusing on 10 fragrances, 10 classic men's fragrances that are guaranteed to put hair on your chest. So make sure to stay tuned. So before I begin this video and I tell you about these 10 classic men's fragrances that are guaranteed to put hair on your chest, kind of a funny topic for a video. I know it was a tag video. I don't believe I was ever tagged in it, but I always found it to be a pretty cool idea. So here I am with my 10 selections. But before I begin with my picks and I tell you what they are, I do want to mention that if you are a fan of fragrance related content, if you like fragrance reviews or top 10 lists just like this, but also giveaways, unboxings, special guests, and a whole lot more, please do consider supporting this channel by subscribing to it. I would really appreciate it. It would mean a lot to me. All you have to do is click on that red button in the corner. And of course, while you're at it, please be sure to enable notifications by clicking on the bell icon. This way, whenever I do put out these videos, they will get delivered straight to your feed. Never need to worry about missing any of my future uploads. So I think we all know what a 70s and 80s powerhouse type of a fragrance is. These are fragrances that are very green, earthy, masculine, they're mossy, they might have oak moss, lavender, carnation, geranium, pine, patchouli, vetiver. These are really masculine and green, verdant types of men's fragrances. And this was definitely a trend in the 70s and the 80s. We see a lot of fougères and chypre fragrances that have really dominated the men's designer industry of, you know, the 70s and 80s in that time period. So what we're seeing here is a lot of fragrances that contain these notes and a lot of fragrances that have stuck around despite the fact that they are 20, 30, or 40 years old. In the case of one of these fragrances in here, it's 50 years old. So we're going to be taking a look at some classics here, and I'm definitely excited to share with you what they are and what I think about them. So let's go ahead and start things off with the, I believe, the oldest fragrance in this list. And this one by the company Hermes is the very first fragrance that they ever released. And this one is called Equipage. This one came out in 1970, and this is an overdose of carnation, which can be a little spicy. It can have hints of clove in here as well, and also Brazilian rosewood. Really interesting combination of the two. It's spicy, it's floral, it's earthy. It has this lavendery nuance, although lavender is not listed as a note, but it definitely gives off fougère vibes because it does contain a lot of ingredients that you're also gonna find in a fougère fragrance. The citrusy top, the coumarinic base with the cinnamon and the tonka bean, really well done, a masterpiece, if I'm being honest. I really love this one. Very happy that I purchased it. The next fragrance in this list is green and earthy. It has a lavender, it has the oak moss, but it also has basil and lemon verbena. It has a freshness to it, some aromatic properties in here as well. And this one by the company Guilleroche is called Dracar Noir. Of course, nobody is a stranger to this one. We all have that one uncle who wears this one quite a bit, and I really do enjoy this one. I find it to be a classic. Of course, a lot of people would feel a bit uneasy about wearing this fragrance today, but I've always been a proponent of the thought or the mindset that if you love wearing it, please continue to wear it despite what other people are saying. And this one definitely gives off that classic vibe, and of course, it will put hair on your chest, as the title of the video indicates down below. The next fragrance that I want to talk about is the original Versace L'Homme. And this one is oak moss and lemon. This has a really natural and bright lemony introduction. As a matter of fact, it's a very realistic smelling lemon, and it's the first thing you're going to notice about this fragrance as soon as you spray it on. However, once you give it a few minutes to dissipate and settle down, you are going to get those mossy elements that come to the fore. And of course, with a lot of these fragrances, they do utilize the note of oak moss so that, you know, kind of conveys that virility or that masculinity. The next fragrance is actually more centered around the note of patchouli, and this one by the company Givenchy is the original Givenchy Gentleman. This has this really creamy and chocolatey patchouli note that I love, and it's so well done. Of course, we have a lot more fragrances that were released more recently. Of course, over the past few years, we've had Noir de Noir by Tom Ford. We also have a few other fragrances that kind of utilize that chocolatey patchouli ingredient, but this one was among the first, if not the first, and I love the way that it smells in here. Very well done. Also another one that I'm super happy that I purchased. The next fragrance in here is the original Lacoste for Men. Now this one is lime and oak moss. So it has this bright citrusy freshness in the opening, and lime is a very unique note, but oak moss is unquestionably the strongest ingredient that you're gonna get in this one. And this one actually smells quite similar to another fragrance, which instead of having lime and oak moss is tobacco and oak moss. And this one is the original Jaguar for Men. So in my humble opinion, I do find that these two smell very similar as opposed to some of the other ones. Like this one has more of that carnation and Brazilian rosewood, that eugenol and geraniol vibe. This one has the freshness. This one has the lemon. This one has that chocolatey patchouli. But these two are very heavy-handed on the note of oak moss. And that's pretty much what one would expect from a fragrance coming out of the 70s and the 80s, of course. So the next fragrance in here has geranium, it has carnation, it has oak moss, a little bit of lavender, that bright bergamot opening, but it also has aldehydes in here that create that sparkling, effervescent appeal in the opening. And this one by Oscar de la Renta is called Oscar Por Louis. And awesome fragrance, very classic and masculine and guaranteed to put hair on your chest, right? The next fragrance that I want to talk about is more of a sandalwood, creamy and leathery fragrance while also possessing a verdant undercurrent. This one by the company Pierre Cardin is called Paul Monsieur. And so this is the original Pierre Cardin fragrance for men. And this one is green, but it also has that spicy, leathery thing going on in the base. And all of these fragrances are rather strong. So no matter which one you choose to wear, you can guarantee that they're gonna last on your skin quite a long time because they do rely on a lot of base notes, like, you know, the oak moss and the vetiver and the patchouli and all of these darker ingredients. And so you can expect these to last a very long time on your skin. And of course, with Pierre Cardin's Paul Monsieur is no exception. The second fragrance, or the number two fragrance that I want to talk about on this list, is one that I personally love. I also had the pleasure of reviewing it over the past few months, and I'm so happy that I included this in the list and I added this to my collection because this is such a unique fragrance for a green fragrance that also utilizes the note of honey. This one is called Lapidus Porum by Ted Lapidus. And I'm sure a lot of you have smelled this one before. It's a very iconic fragrance. And it also has like this animalic quality in the base that it's not listed in the note breakdown, but I'm definitely picking up on it. It almost smells like civet to me. And so if you're familiar with the note of civet, I'm kind of getting a little bit of that in this fragrance. And it adds this sort of mysterious quality to the fragrance. And I like the fact that it utilizes that honey note because it makes it stand apart from other fragrances that would fall under this classification. And of course, that leaves us with the number one spot. Could it be Kouros by Yves Saint Laurent? Could it be any number of other masculine fragrances? And of course, I could have done this with so many other fragrances. If you would like to see a part two, or if you want me to do the same concept but with 10 different fragrances, let me know. Leave a comment down below. I'm always happy to entertain that. But this one is a Jacques Polge creation. This one is such a classic, and I purchased this several years ago. And it wasn't necessarily love at first sniff for me, but I definitely came around to it. And I should also mention that if you are entering a hairy chest contest, you don't even need to take your shirt off. You can just tell the attendant that you're wearing this fragrance and you will automatically win. I'm just kidding. This one by the company Chanel is called Antaeus. And this, very much like the Greek, you know, god statues, is a very sort of masculine and classic fragrance. You have the oak moss, you have the patchouli, you have lavender, you have rose, you have a little bit of a leathery nuance going on in the base, but more importantly, you have this animalic note of castoreum. And castoreum is a bit more easygoing than civet. I would say just as easygoing as ambergris or some other leathery notes, if you will, or musks. But this one, super strong, very masculine. You have that mossy quality, the leathery component. You have that sensual yet masculine rose in the heart of the composition. Just a very well done fragrance by Jacques Polge and an iconic fragrance from the house of Chanel. So There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. This was just a fun video, very haphazard and random, but these are 10 men's fragrances that are guaranteed to put hair on your chest, and these ultimately are just 10 classic men's fragrances that do remind me of decades past, whether we're talking about the 70s, 80s, or early 90s. I'm also curious to know, what would your top 10 picks be, or what are your top 3, just to make it a little easier? Leave a comment down below. I'm always interested in hearing from you guys, and of course, if you are new to this channel, and you took something of value from this video, or if you found this video to just be fun, please do show your support by subscribing to this channel. All you have to do is click on that red button in the corner, and of course, remember to enable notifications by clicking on the bell. Thanks again for watching. Love you all, and we'll see you soon. Bye.